is climate change real? In a highly polarized world, we often come across this question. It has been a major policy issue all around the globe, and if it is indeed real, the consequences are severe and long-lasting. Let's follow the conversation between Dorland and Goethe to find out the answer for ourselves. We derive our data from verified government sources including NASA, NOAA, and climate.gov so that you can make an unbiased and informed decision. From this graph of global temperature anomaly with respect to the 20th century average, we see how the temperature has increased over the years and how it continues to increase. Let's move our focus to the United States. The average temperature of the United States has increased by 2.4 degrees Fahrenheit over the last century. Even the smallest change in temperature corresponds to enormous changes in the environment. Here we look at the states and counties of the United States in detail. It is evident that warmer states experience lesser increase in temperature as compared to the colder states. We can also see how temperature of states have varied over the years, the temperature change in the individual counties, and the ranking of states based on temperature change. Dorland here poses an important question. What is causing the increase in temperature? Years of research has attributed greenhouse gases as the primary cause. Amongst all the greenhouse gases, it is carbon dioxide that is being emitted the most. Further, we can also see that an increase in carbon dioxide is in line with the increase in global surface temperature anomaly. What is surprising is that it is just 10 countries that account for more than 60% of the world's carbon dioxide emissions. We analyzed the sources for these emissions for the top 5 countries. Electricity and heat production from the burning of fossil fuels is a major source, followed by manufacturing and transportation. So how does an increase in temperature really affect us? We see that the glaciers are melting and sea levels are rising. Scientists predict that entire cities will be abandoned due to threats from rising sea levels. This includes major urban hubs like New York City, Miami, and Tokyo. We will also see an increase in frequency and severity of climate extremes, such as forest fires, tornadoes, hurricanes, droughts, and heat waves. Let us consider California, which has recently seen a massive increase in the number of forest fires. Climate change is a global phenomenon and it impacts all the countries. But are all countries affected equally? Well, not really. It can be seen that countries with higher GDP and population tend to produce more CO2 emissions. But these are not the most vulnerable ones. Indigene Country Index measures a country's readiness to the effects of climate change. Lower indigene value means higher vulnerability. As we can see here, most African countries that have little contribution to the increase in carbon dioxide emissions are more vulnerable to the effects of climate change. At the end of this conversation, Goethe might not be able to convince Dorland, but we hope that you are convinced that climate change is real. Here are a few things that you can do to help.
Stop chopping down our trees, stop using plastic things, carpool and drive EVs, and give back to the earth we've been given. Cut down the milk and meat, green power, the lights and heat. We'll sing this song on repeat as we do our part for the world that we live in.
Join the fight against climate change and make our planet great again.